This is March 4th, 2016, and it's Friday. And I'm Pam Scannell. This is my husband, Steve Scannell.
How do you do?
And this is show number 51, and it's Cape Cod Training Base Hyannis. Thank you.
Thank you, my beautiful wife, Pam.
Thank you.
And in 10 days, we're going to be married 1 year. Yippee.
Yep.
Yippee. Okay, Cape Cod Training Base Hyannis is an idea that is spawned from the new fire department proposal. I do believe that Hyannis needs a new fire department. Most everyone does believe that. You know, the old one's getting a little raggedy. Mm-hmm. And they're putting up with a lot. It's a pretty busy, it's an extremely busy fire department in Hyannis. Very, very busy station. And they do a very good job. Mm-hmm. And I voted for their new station every time it comes up. Now, Cape Cod Training Base Hyannis would be part of what I call a consortium. And a consortium is usually considered a partnership in the general nature of something that the government can't do alone and private enterprise really can't do it alone either. Thank you. Now, this is not something we have to rush on, and I'm definitely going to vote for this new fire station. Would be nice if I came up with this idea a lot earlier, but it just hit me and I started working on it. Now, it would have, this Cape Cod training base would be a consortium, you see. So I want to explain that first of all. And the consortium would include, let's say, for argument's sake, a dozen training bases throughout the United States, all in resort areas, because the purpose would be partially family fun for the, let's say, fireman or government worker or police, etc., that is going to the training. So family fun, bring your wife, bring your kids, or bring your significant other, let's say. Now, part of that, if we did the first one, which is not likely, I think 12 of them would be more likely to be done together, and this would be a federal program mostly. But it would be medical, Cape Cod Hospital would be part of the consortium, Cape Cod Community College would be part of this training-based consortium, and Boston Hospitals, and the EMT and trauma units of all the towns, et cetera. They would all be a part of it. Also inclusive would be improvements such as dorms for the Cape Cod Community College and probably a UMass outfit down here somewhere on the Cape to fit into this. Mm-hmm. Now, this would be a consortium. One of many would be Hyannis. And I just thought off the top of my head that another training base would be Puerto Rico. Another one would be Hawaii. Another training base may be located in Guam. And I'll tell you why. Another training base might be in District of Columbia and Hyannis. That would be our training base if we played our cards right. And then Port St. Lucie, Florida. Mm-hmm. And then maybe Virginia Beach, Virginia. And so the nature of the beast here is that you're providing training for these young families who are in fire departments or in the government generally, and their family is brought along. So that's a value-added training facility in various locations. Now, as they say, now how much would you pay? Okay, we're going to add to that. The United Nations and the State Department and various foundations are going to be in on this if this plan would be picked up. And I'm realistic, and I know nobody's watching the show. It's a sleep aid at this point. But if this show were picked up and got noticed, and this idea made sense to a few people, then maybe it could carry on. Now, so you wouldn't just have Cape Cod Community College and UMass and New England states involved. You would also have the United Nations.
I think it's getting noticed.
Our State Department. Thank you. and foundations would be in on this. So the anchor for the Hyannis bid would be this Main Street plus, you know, this training base, plus we've got the new hockey rink and the beaches and the harbor. So Hyannis has multiple anchors and the transportation center and the airport, et cetera. So Hyannis is pretty dynamic. So I would say Hyannis and the local outlying communities would probably come in for about $40 million on a project like this, which would be well worth it. Our portion may be 10%. So for the entire Cape and Islands and Southeast Mass, it might cover that that kind of a range. Housing and hotel comes with the package. In other words, when we built the humongous model for the fire department, let's just say it would be I've got it drawn up as a 7-story building with a chapel, and that chapel would be the chapel across the street. I've got it drawn up here, but it's not ready to be shown. So we would start out with a dozen of these training bases all in the USA and all in areas that were very highly desirable to go on vacation. Let's just say the Flagstaff, Arizona would be a big one. And where else? The Redwood Forest, you know, San Francisco area. And then Hollywood. Where do you go for Hollywood?
Vero Beach.
Vero Beach is too close to Port St. Lucie. But you never know, it might be located down in Vero Beach. But I can say Port St. Lucie is one of the best run communities in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
You want a couple of things. You want the best run community. You want transportation logistics to be doable, if possible. And you also want it to be a place where people would really, really want to go for 2 or 3 weeks. Because in the clubhouse world, we have a training base here in Worcester. And that's where people from all over the world come to be trained in clubhouse, in the clubhouse model. So this is partially from the clubhouse mindset, this whole thing about a training base. So I can see down the road, if this were funded by the United Nations and funded by the State Department, that we could take some of our foreign aid budget and fund this whole thing. And there'd be arrival by boats for 1,000 people a month from Africa, just from Africa, to go to these training bases. And it might show up in Hyannis, or it might show up in Boston. Get on a train and go to your training base. Okay. So Cape Cod would be acting like a city. We call ourselves a city. I really don't, but I guess most people consider Barnstable to be a city. I can't get it through my thick skull that it is a city, but it is. Because I was born here in Hyannis, you know.
I think Hyannis is a city.
You do? Okay.
Yeah.
So we need to get them out to see the Cape. They need to be trained. And they need to have some family fun. So that's about the gist of the thing here. Now, all the New England fire associations and the regional fire training, et cetera, like our county training base over on the other side of Hyannis Airport, these would all be involved. It would be very much fireman's training, a base would be worked in, but not entirely. That would be a pretty good percentage. And then your local B&Bs might be a theme for, you know, you might have a cottage out behind your house. And we need to take all this foreign money and channel it and funnel it into these training bases. We're spending our foreign aid budget the wrong way. We need to invite people to the USA, train them, give them a good time, and then get them going back. Now, I saw a program on TV just the other day. And what was that program called? I think it was the SEED training. One of the hospitals in Boston was training people from Africa. This got me going too. This woman from one of the hospitals, I forget her name, in Boston, has a huge training program, and she has the African, it looked like mostly ladies, but it was, you know, from an area in Africa, a country where they have very few doctors per with their population. So she was in the business of getting these people on their footing. Now, what better way to spend money than to do this project and help Africa. I'd like to ask you that. Now, Cape Cod wouldn't be handling the whole load. This would have to be orchestrated. And I am proposing that we go with Puerto Rico, but I would insist that Rhode Island absorb Puerto Rico. I know that sounds silly, but Rhode Island can build its own ferry boat, and they need a little bit more territory. Why give it to Florida when you can give it to Puerto Rico? We need to absorb Guam and the U.S. Virgin Islands and American Samoa into the United States proper. I don't like having these situations where, you know, like in Washington, D.C., they claim it's taxation without representation. Washington, D.C. people vote, but they don't vote for their own senator. They don't have a senator. That's not right. Well, we need to straighten out a few housekeeping details. That would be one of them, that Puerto Rico would be absorbed into the USA proper and become part of a state. I'm comfortable absorbing them into Rhode Island, as I said. I'm mm-hmm. insisting on that. Isn't that funny? Mm-hmm. What would we call it? Rhode Rico? No, we could call it Puerto Rico. It would just be part of Rhode Island. And Guam could probably be absorbed into Hawaii. But these are structural changes. Now, this would be a major structural change for our funding of foreign aid. So this is a federal idea. It's really not a Hyannis idea. But I got the idea because I'm dreaming about a new fire department for these people. These mm-hmm. are great people. Mm-hmm. And they certainly deserve, in my book, a fire department mm-hmm. that's worthy of their good efforts.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Can I sidetrack for a second? Mm-hmm. I want to go to my resume. Just wrote up a resume because I'm going to be getting back into tractor, trailer, truck driving, and they insisted I have a resume. So this says, and this will be part of my agenda to work on my resume. Stephen J. F. Scannell, 168 Barnstable Road, Apartment 5J, Hyannis, Mass., 02601. Environmental fisherman, and there's my email, which you don't like. Currently a member of Baybridge Clubhouse, that's a DMH clubhouse, and I'm a volunteer there. I do research and development of complex systems, as seen on the TV show The Scannell Agenda, which is on YouTube. 2002 to 2016, PCA caregiver, help with administration and payroll work, student at Cape Cod Community College, Environmental Science, 3.25 GPA, 78 credits, and peer advocate for mentally ill, etc. 1976 to 2002, Harwich High School graduate, 1976. Unfortunate vehicular homicide, 1975, which I'm responsible for. Commercial fisherman, both self-employed and on offshore boats, since 1972. Activist for fisheries, published and peer-reviewed, elected official on Nantucket on a small fisheries-related board, labor, laminator of wooden boats, cabinet shop worker, taxi driver 5 years on Nantucket, truck and bus driver, Nantucket and Cape Cod, honest and hardworking, 508-360-1926. My resume. Mm-hmm. I didn't have on there that I was a firefighter, but that's just a volunteer position on Nantucket.
That's still good.
That's still a good thing. A lot of people do that. It's less of the thing to do now that we're all with this business of all these professional firefighters. I don't know where that's going. Maybe that'll be permanent. I'm not sure. But in the old days, the volunteer fire departments really carried 80% of the load. In some towns it was 100% volunteer driven. But now that the fire departments all have the ambulance services too, that has helped out tremendously to provide a great crew for most of the fire departments. So this idea about the Cape Cod training base in Hyannis, it's not about the fire department building. Now, if a miracle happened, it could be. This idea could fit into this broader idea, that is this idea of a new fire department. Of course, if you were building it from scratch and you had the approval for this idea, all done, Congress voted, and Hyannis said, we're going to do it. Hyannis was chosen. They said they were going to do it. They could do it. But Hyannis could very well do it. Now, one of the reasons for that is this would be a multiple services training base, generally for the government, but you would have also the military would be involved, because you got Hyannis is very close to the Joint Base Cape Cod. So you would have an international aspect there where you could have the military from different governments participating with the militaries of the USA. And since your kids are going to be coming along, I've thrown in pizza training school.
Well,
and we need student teachers. Of course, mm-hmm. if you're going to invite a family, and let's say you have a kid and the kid wants to work, make some money, you're in America, don't hold them back. Let them work,
mm-hmm.
right?
Mm-hmm.
The kids love to work, I know that.
Mm-hmm.
As well as go to the beach, of course. Now, I figured Dad would be in training from 5 a.m. to 11 a.m., and then the rest of the day would be with the family. That's 6 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And the ambulance can come wake up Dad and put him on a stretcher, and that could be part of the training. I think of all this stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And spouse training, too. If you're a fisherman or you're a mariner, and you're the spouse of a fisherman or a mariner, you need special training to handle that. That's a stressor. And, of course, if you're a military wife or husband, that's training, too, that you need to be a good husband or wife to your partner who's in the military. So this would be part of that sociological training. So these would be 2 or 3 week trainings. Now, as I get back to Hyannis here, Barnstable has had an excellent training school for the town of Barnstable, training in the government. So all we would have to do in Barnstable with this program here, if this were accepted, were to really biggie size it. And then be inclusive of other towns, too, which would participate. It wouldn't be all about Hyannis doing it all. It would be about the Cape and Islands doing it all as far as the training for government workers. Let's say from Africa, South America, Europe, etc. The social services, too, would be involved. And even things like a 12-step or a clubhouse or PCA training. All that stuff.
12-step would be good.
Yeah, all that stuff would be thrown in for good measure. And that's why I included the chapel as part of the police station. I mean the fire station. So agency systems, etc., leadership training with the Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, since you'd be involving the families. All this stuff could be thrown in. These people come in here for 2 or 3 weeks or longer would have a great tour of the Cape. And then maybe they'd have a week tour, they'd go to some other part of the country and just have a vacation, and it would be a month or even longer, because while you're here, you might as well see the country. So this would fit in too with another one of my projects, which I call Marine Technologies Educational Program, which would be high school and college here on the Cape. That'd be sail training, boat building, fishing, equipment, electronics.
Would you include the friends of prisoners with that, with the boat building?
Thank you. Thank you very much for pointing that out.
It's also called Gwinden House.
Gwinden House and friends of prisoners for building boats, and also with the county jail, too. Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
I don't believe in putting someone out of jail without a job.
And Gwinden House is on Bierce's Way.
Right, and your brother Kevin, who was
is
on the
director.
Last show, is the director. Now, years ago, Kevin and I talked, when you and I were good friends at Baybridge many years ago,
mm-hmm.
I've been proposing this idea that disabled people, friends of prisoners, build these beautiful wooden boats. Not of my design, of course. These are Herrschaft boats, and they'd be sail training. And the nature of that beast would be sail training with chartering, because as your kids grow up with these boats, you want to get them their captain's license so they can put themselves through college and maybe own a boat and do charter work.
And Kevin is for this too.
Kevin would love to see anything like this happen as mm-hmm. well. I'm sure the sheriff, Sheriff Cummings, would love it if there was a place where his inmates could go and be guaranteed a job. This is a guaranteed job for disabled people in that they're not working with the chemicals, with my systems of hot molding. They're not my systems. These systems have been around for many years. Hot molding a boat would mean you staple the laminated wood together. And it could be a 26-foot boat, a 52-foot boat, or a 104-foot boat. It would be the same process. You'd staple the wood together. You'd put these wooden baskets, if you want to call them that, into an autoclave and add the plastic. And think of your salad bowl, your beautiful laminated salad bowl that used to be quite popular. Well, that's all we're talking about here. It's impregnated wood, that's hot molding. Looters had these boats for years, and they're still sailing, and they're still for sale. So there's a lot that plugs into this. That's a very important thing to plug into Cape Cod Training Base Hyannis, because you want to have these training bases offer a variety to the world, and not just New England. So I was thinking also that New England Tractor Trailer Training School could have a campus, because if you've got firemen training, well, they've got some pretty huge pieces of heavy equipment to drive around, so we could have a track and a training field for heavy equipment, tractor trailer truck operations, and a truck stop, and I was just mentioning that we needed a truck stop here, and I was at a Duffy meeting, and I said what we need for people to do their laundry is actually we need a truck stop to take them to, where they can do their laundry, and I wasn't kidding. That would be the ideal. Showers, and a clubhouse needs showers too, but we don't have that. So one of the things that would make Cape Cod a good place for firefighting training too would be that we could have small forest fires that the firemen could put out. And in a way, that's probably pretty good for Mother Nature, as long as you're in control. Equipment maintenance, we could have a county shop too, that'd be good. And bus driving and a chaplain service, I've got that involved here. Coast Guard, local fire and rescue partnerships. Now in Britain they have a system whereby their local rescue is done with all volunteer life-saving service, it's called, I think. That's in Britain. So the good thing about training is it gives you confidence, whether you're mentally ill and you're going to a training base, one of many for Clubhouse International, or whether you're going to a training base for government services and military, fire, police, government services for a small town, et cetera, et cetera. These would be intensive training experiences for yourself as a professional in government and the family. So I think that gives us a lot of bang for the buck, and funded mostly through the federal government and the United Nations. Other countries would cough up some of their budget to send their people to get trained. This would kind of go with an idea that I have for democracy insurance, I call it, whereby you have a vote in your country. Let's say you have a small African country, and you have a vote to buy an insurance policy to continue and indemnify your democracy against all comers. You know, you'd pretty much guarantee your democracy. You would not have to have a standing military, because all you'd have to do, and we'd watch here in the USA, all you'd have to do is say, hey, Uncle Joe came in and took over the country, and we'd say, well, wait a minute here, we have the policy. You can't do that. Uncle Joe, we're sorry, but these people are insured against that. Hit the road. Of course, they're going to hit the road. They're not even going to They're not even going to start with that business. Poor Africa has a problem. They have a democracy and they get it going and it's working just fine, you know. And then, lo and behold, someone comes in and starts a ruckus and takes over the government and you're back to square one and you're put back. That's not good. So this is part and parcel of democracy insurance for small countries. So don't spend your money on the military. Don't do it. Spend your money on the insurance policy and on training, and we'll have you up and running. You can use Cape Cod as a model. Here comes Jamie with the time. It's probably 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. And it's 2 minutes. Have I been yakking that much? I've been rattling on. So this is Cape Cod Training Base Hyannis. Government services, medical, fire. And in the center of it all is family fun. And yippee for your family if you get chosen to come to America. It'll probably be about 60% foreign and 40% Americans. Because we'll be channeling and funneling the federal budget for aid to other countries through this program. There'll be about 12 of them in the country to start with. So what do you think about that, Pam?
It sounds good, and Friends of Prisoners could be involved.
Definitely.
It sounds very good.
Yeah, one of my next shows is going to be on that. I'm going to dedicate a whole show for that.
Good.
All right, well, that is, can you wrap it up?
Sure. Thank you for listening, Cape Cod. God bless you.